Hello everyone, my name is Vimal Raj. I'm a lecturer from GEMS Polytechnic College from the department Mechanical. So today we are going to discuss on the unit number 5, that is the solid waste management, and this is the lecture number 23, and the today's topic is going to be solution of radioactive pollution, and this is from the subject called environmental and pollution control, and the subject code is 162503. So the content that we're going to discuss today is solution of radioactive pollution. First one is the proper method of disposing radioactive waste. Radioactive waste still has some level of radiation. So accordingly, it cannot be disposed in the same way as the normal waste. It cannot be incinerated or buried, since there are likelihood of seepage. This waste should be stored in heavy and thick concrete containers. Another option is to dilute the radiation, since storage may not be possible. Since there are no easy ways of disposing of radioactive materials, professional assistance should always be sought. So basically, there is no waste to dispose the radioactive waste, because even though if the radioactive waste, if it's a waste from a radioactive, still it has some level of radiation, so it could affect. So basically what they will do is, they cannot go and just bury it, or they cannot do this incinerated process or something like that. So basically it has this CPA, so that it will be easily can be spreaded. So this waste has to be stored in the heavy and thick concrete containers. It should be stored in the containers basically, and another option could be, it could be diluted so that it can be stored for the maybe it could not be stored. And the next option, it could be disposing it. Since there is no easy way for disposing this radioactive materials, it should be consulted with a profession who is particularly dealing with this kind of radioactive things. So he will be helping to overcome this thing. So some of the process like ores, so enrichment, LWR fuel fabrications. So this is a process, some kind of process where in which these things, the fuel, all these things will happen. So next is the proper labeling. So basically, proper labeling is nothing but we have to label these chemicals in the proper names, because the person who is going to use it, if it's not matched, or if the name is not mentioned correctly, what happens is he might tend to use a different chemical, so which will lead to a big destruction. So if suppose he is taking a bottle of sulfuric acid instead of taking a normal agent, so if the name is not written, simply take the hydrochloric acid. If he is using in his hand, his hands would have been burning, his hands would have burned. Right, so it is very necessary for any material with radioactive contents to be labeled, and necessary precaution advised on the content of the label. So basically, any radioactive material is there, it has to be mentioned clearly, and it should be advised with the precautionary steps that how to handle this. So the reason for this is to because radiation can enter the body by mere touch of a radioactive material. So basically, how this radioactive will work is, if there is a material of a radioactive thing is there, so if you touch it, it will enter our body without any problem. So containers with such elements should be well labeled in order for one to use protective gears with handling them. So basically, whenever they handle this radioactive materials, they should use it in a proper way with handling using protective gears also. Next one is the banning of the nuclear test. So basically, it has already been proven that nuclear power has a lot of latent power that is very destructive. Nevertheless, the test done to perfect the energy contribute greatly to the overall presence of radioactive substance. Moreover, these tests through done in the deserts end up escaping from one ecosystem to another, eventually affecting the lives of the many people. So something which is very, very important, banning of the nuclear test, because nuclear test should not be done in a place. But nowadays, some ages, some places, they do it in the desert. So finally, they end up losing their lives because people who do the test and all. This nuclear is not a, it's a small one. It's a fission, right? Nuclear, it's a continuous process. Nuclear fusion, nuclear fission, like that continuous process is there. So it will be keep on going. It cannot be controlled just like that. So what happens is when they are doing this test means finally they will end up in losing their lives. So which is a bad one. So in order to control that, what they have to do is they have to ban this nuclear test, because anyways this nuclear is going to harm, because we know that it produces a lateral, I mean a big amount of power that is very destructive. Anything which comes in front of it, it will destroy. So that much power is there with the nuclear weapons. So government should ban this nuclear test, because in order to protect the nation, in order to protect the people, so they have to do it. They have to do that. There is no other choice. In order to control the ecosystem, because we know that what the radiation can do. If the radiation is affecting one person, that will stay in that body permanently, because energy can either be created nor be destroyed. So it always stay in the body, which will lead to the genetic mutation. So whoever is having contact with them, they will also be affected with their physical relationship. That is a major problem, because the person who has been affected with the radiation, if he is having a physical relationship with another person, he will also be infected, and the generation will be having a genetic mutation, and the DNA strands will be shaken off, and they might end up with a blindness, a physical problem. People will be physically challenged. So many things are there. So many things are there. So which is very, very dangerous. Alternate energy sources. So the evolution and the use of nuclear power was not a bad thing initially. However, considering the damage and threats it has on the environment, it is a high time for its use to be discontinued and for the world to perhaps focus on alternative and environmental friendly. So basically this is nothing but alternate energy source. If suppose only way to produce power is only nuclear, thing is not like that, right? What is the alternative method? So everything has an alternate. See, anything is there, there could be an alternate method will be there. Alternate solution is there. So there is no question that has only one answer. Might have an alternative answer, but the answer is the same, but alternative methods are there. I would say alternate methods are there. So nuclear power is not only the only source. There are some other power like renewable source of energy, like solar, hydroelectric, wind power. The use of radioactivity to generate energy in nuclear power plant, for example, leads to the production of more radiation. So that's the reason people who work in this nuclear power plants and all, they will be given holidays for 6 months, and the remaining 6 months they have to work, because you know what, continuous checkup will be there. They will not be working for the full month. 15 days they will work, 15 days they will be given a holiday. You know what, these people are really exposed to this radiation, and the generation is in trouble actually. And they have been paid a lot, because they are risking their life, they are risking their generation for this job. So they'll be paid enormous amount of money. But what is the use of money? With that money everything can be done? No. Life is something which is very, very, very precious. It cannot be consolidated, or it cannot be bargained with money. So people who work in this power plants and all, nuclear power plant, please, you have to think, because you have to think your generation. See, nuclear power plant is not the only way to produce the energy. There are so many other alternative ways, like the hydroelectric power plants are there, wind power plants, the solar power plants, so many things are there. But it takes some time. But you know what, people want everything to be done at a single point of time. They don't want to spend money, they don't want to spend time actually. even though they are ready to pay money, they don't want to spend the time. So when you go for hydroelectric or wind power plant, it will take some time, right? So even though wind power plants, if you take, means if the wind is blowing, then only things will be running. So if the wind is not there, it will not run. But when it comes to the nuclear power plant, it's not like that. The first thing, energy released, energy has been stored, used. But the damage that gives, the damage that we get is more, which is uncomparable. Alternate energy source: geothermal, wind, solar, electric, biomass. So these are the other alternative energy sources that we can go for. It will take some time, but the results are the same. It will take some time, that is for sure. Not like nuclear power plant. See, recently there is an accident in a power plant. You know what? How many people died? Chernobyl attack. How many people? Chernobyl disaster. How many people died, lost their lives because of this? Because of nuclear power plants. Because these nuclear power plants will have enormous amount of energy stored. So when it goes for explosion, damn sure that the explosion will be very, very terrible, and the radiation that affects the person will be more. Proper storage. So next one is the proper storage. See, anything has to be stored in a proper way. See, if it's a milk is there, can you keep the milk all the time outside? It will be spoiled, right? So you have to keep it in the fridge. So there is some storage places there where we have to keep things. We cannot go and keep the dress in the fridge. We cannot keep the milk in the cupboard. So everything has a place where it has to be stored. The same thing. So it is mandatory for container carrying radioactive materials to be stored properly. So the materials, the radioactive materials that is going to be used, has to be stored in a proper place in such a way that nothing, this has no bad thing should happen. So for starters, such substance should be stored in a radiation proof containers to ensure no seeping or leakage during the handling. So they have to do a double check whether any seepage is or seeping is happening or leakage is happening. So proper storage means no harm and can minimize cases of accidental leakages as well as. So these things will be considered in the fact, because everything has to be stored in a proper place so that nothing bad happens. Next is the reusing. Since it is not easy to store or dispose the waste, it can be recycled and used for other purpose, like in other reactor as a fuel, thereby protecting the environment. So basically, when it goes to the reusing, these energies that stored, right, can also be used for another another process. So that it can be again be used for producing that. See, if storage is a problem, then they can go for the reusing. So reusing means again they can reuse it, because the energy has been released. Energy has been released because of that. You know what? We get enough amount of energy so that we can be used it. Can use it. So it can be recycled and used for other purposes, like in other reactors as a fuel. With that, we just come to the conclusion. So today in detail, we just did a study on the solution of radioactive pollution. This is a reference book. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. We will see in the next video with the next topic.